The next speaker is Sri K. K. Ragesh. I'll check if it is unparliamentary, it will be expunged. Mr. Ragesh.
Sir, time. Thank you, sir. Sir, to begin with, I am requesting the Honorable Minister to take steps to rename the proposed tribal university as Rohit Bemula Tribal University, who was succumbed to institutional murder. Sir, while welcoming this bill to establish two universities in the state of Andhra Pradesh, I take this opportunity to bring certain pertinent issues that confront our education sector, especially the higher education sector in our country, before the Honorable Minister. Sir, as we all know, that the universities are the dwelling places of ideas and idealism. They are supposed to create knowledge. They are the centers where knowledge production is being taken place. And if we are depending on private universities or foreign universities for knowledge creation, sir, it will amount to an intellectual dependency on these institutions. So I think it is extremely important to strengthen our public-funded university system in our country. I am saying this by keeping the new education policy of the government in mind. Sir, we are making a lot many rhetorical statements so far as the world-class universities, institutes are concerned. How many universities in our country have got that world-class tag? Sir, if you go through the QS World University ranking, and if you take 400 top universities in the world, do we have a single university that ranked within 400 world-class universities? No, sir. So why we are making such kind of rhetorical statements, sir? And I want to know from the Honorable Minister what efforts that we are taking for ensuring the quality of our education university system, sir. Sir, if you look at the central universities, you can see that 8,000 posts, teaching posts, are lying vacant, and 40% of the total faculty is appointed on temporary basis. Sir, I don't know whether any person with good academic credential will opt for a temporary faculty. No, sir. So all these things affect our university, quality of our university education system. And again, vast majority of the students are depending upon state universities and affiliated colleges. And what support that the UGC is giving to those universities? Budgetary allocation for education, especially for higher education, has been drastically reduced. We know that right from Kothari Commission had recommended for providing to ensure 6% of the GDP on education, and you, in your election manifesto, also had made that as a point. But what is the status? If you want to ensure 6% of the GDP on education, you have to earmark at least 10% of the central budget on education. And what is the status? Sir, budgetary allocation is also drastically being reduced. In 2014-15, total budget expenditure was 4.1%. And last year, total expenditure was 3.17%, sir. But you may be making some nominal increase, but when you take the whole budget, budgetary allocation as a percentage, it is getting declined year after year.
Please come.
And what happened? One more minute. And what happened to the education sector? Right from 2014, we are collecting education tax, and as per the CAG reports, 94,000 crores of rupees is lying there as unspent. This is on the basis of the CAG report. You are collecting, imposing cess on cess 3% has been imposed for education, and that remains unspent, and that too at a time when our universities are starving of funds, when the quality of education is getting deteriorated, when our university system is getting privatized, and you are depending on private players, you are depending on foreign players. Sir, this is not the way. This is not
Thank
the way.
You
have to strengthen
Thank
the university
you,
system, public funded university system, and I am appealing the government to take steps for ensuring the quality education to our children, and by
Thank
strengthening
I have to go to
the public
speaker.
Sector, public funded education system. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.